everybody. This is Charu Mehrotra, founder of online magazine Womenlines.com. Today we are having somebody very special from India. He is Vijay Bhat. Vijay Bhat's first career, which was for 25 years, was in advertising. His second career, which was for 13 years, was in leadership. And now he is having his third career. He is founder of Cancer Awakens. Vijay is himself a 17-year thriver from colon cancer and the co-author with his wife Nilima for My Cancer Is Me Book, which outlines holistic and integrated approach to cancer. Hi Vijay.
Hi Charu.
Welcome to Womenlines.
Thank you for having me.
So please Vijay, please share about yourself.
Well, you have already introduced me very nicely. So all I will say is that you know, when I had cancer 17 years ago, I was very fortunate to get extremely good help in the very early days of my journey.
Interesting.
But what I notice is that most people who get cancer, and cancer is growing very rapidly these days, most people don't get good help. So they are devastated, the family is devastated, all that is natural, but if you get good help, then your chances of coming out of cancer healed is much higher. So what I decided to do in my third career is really to figure out a way by which we can help people from the very early days of their diagnosis, through their treatment, and after their treatment, so that we can really accompany them on their journey alongside what the doctors are doing on the medical
front. Interesting. So as we are looking forward at Womenlines, we will be sharing content from Cancer Awakens. So can you share how Cancer Awakens content is going to help our readers? What is there?
So let me approach that in two ways. The first is that Womenlines is an online magazine that is targeting women.
Correct.
Now you may have noticed, but just like all cancers are on the rise, women's cancers are growing actually very, very rapidly.
There's so many updates around news, it's
so
scary.
For example, breast cancer is become rampant.
Very true.
Ovarian cancer, cervical cancer, uterine cancer, plus the general cancers like lymphomas and leukemias and so on. So I think that women need to pay particular attention to what they can do to prevent cancer.
Right.
And if they are diagnosed with it, what they can do to heal from cancer. So therefore, I feel that Cancer Awakens has a lot of relevant messaging for women. The second thing is that in Cancer Awakens, we don't focus on the medical side.
Awesome. I love that part.
We focus on the non-medical side and on the human side.
Beautiful. I mean, that should be the approach. How holistically we can cure things in life, that will be better for us.
Yeah. And also the last thing is that in most cases, if a man gets cancer, his spouse or his daughter might become his primary caregiver.
Very true.
But if women get cancer, the question is who becomes their primary
big
caregiver?
Question. Definitely a big question.
So therefore, I think on all these three fronts, the message from Cancer Awakens and the material from Cancer Awakens is very relevant.
Awesome. And plus, I love the part where you share about how we can enhance our immunity, what are the stress points in life. So there's so much to learn from Vijay. I'm really looking forward to share the content at Womenlines. Awesome. So now please, Vijay, share some exclusive tips how people can keep cancer away for whole family. What we can do?
Yeah, so cancer is a very mysterious disease.
Okay. Definitely.
So nobody really knows specifically what causes cancer.
Very true.
Even the doctors don't know.
Yeah.
Right? So what everyone tries to do is to deal with it when it happens. But there is a lot of research now slowly coming through which shows that your best chance of defending against cancer is to keep your immunity in top condition.
Very strong points.
Yes. So now if you take that idea forward, that every average human being in their life may have 50 or 70 opportunities to get cancer, but they don't.
Okay.
they don't, because our immunity knows how to track it and deal with it and flush it away. Now, if our immunity is compromised, then the chances of those cells, those mutating cells, turning into cancer are much greater. So what we have to do is, we've got to keep like our, the immunity is like our natural security.
Please take a note. It's important. Yes.
We have to keep our security in good condition.
Very true.
So then the question is,
how to do
that? What compromises the immunity?
Yes. What's the cause?
So the first thing that compromises immunity is stress.
Common word.
Right?
What to do?
So exactly.
What to do?
So most people will say, well, stress is inevitable. What can I do?
Yeah.
But actually, there is plenty you can do.
And okay.
In order for you to do plenty, you must understand what stress is. And there are 5 different sources of stress.
Okay.
So for example, there is physical stress.
Correct.
Which is, you know, your diet, your exercise, mm-hmm. your sleeping habits, mm-hmm. How much you socialize, whether you laugh a lot.
Yes.
Right? These are all things that contribute to physical stress. Then there is emotional stress.
Mm-hmm.
Which is, how do you handle your emotions?
Your own emotions.
Particularly your negative emotions.
Okay.
So if you learn how to handle your negative emotions, mm-hmm. it reduces your stress, improves your immunity.
Oh. Awesome.
Third is mental stress.
Okay.
Mental stress has to do with your thoughts
mm-hmm.
and your beliefs and your values.
The previous stress you mentioned.
No, emotions are about your feelings. Which is heart level.
It's so complicated.
No, it's not actually. Mental stress has to do with your thoughts, with your mind. So when you say mind, body, heart, feelings,
mm-hmm.
they're all different. Right?
Oh, in that perspective. Got it. Okay.
The fourth level is relationships. Okay. If you're in toxic relationships, either at home or at work, it's going to affect you. It's going to cause stress, and the stress is going to drop your immunity.
Hmm.
And the last is, which is a slightly strange one, is spiritual stress.
I never thought about it. What's spiritual stress? I mean, how can spirituality cause stress?
Actually, it's not spirituality that causes stress. It's your disconnection with spirituality that causes stress.
Okay, got it.
So if we become very materialistic, if we disconnect from our spiritual source, if you're not able to answer the big questions of our life, who am I? Where am I going? What is the purpose of my life? Then that causes what we call spiritual stress. So it's very simple. The higher the stress, lower the immunity, the greater the chance of falling ill. And this is not true only of cancer. This is true of a lot of serious illnesses.
Very true.
So that's the game. How can you minimize your stress? Improve your immunity.
Very true. So now we have some content which can really help us and empower us to live life healthy way. Awesome. Looking forward to have that content and share with my readers and viewers. So please do watch out for the content from next one. Thank you so much, Vijay, for your time. All the best.
Thank you, Charu.
Thank you.